Welcome to my final video for 2023. As you probably can tell, I am not in my normal home studio. I'm actually visiting family for the holidays in Utah, and you might also be able to tell a little bit of congestion. That's because I came down with a bit of a flu earlier this week, but thankfully I am on the mend. Now, what I wanted to do, I actually had a different kind of thing planned, but I really needed to be back home. So the thing I had planned, that'll be for 2024. But I still had a really fun idea for a video. And it has to do with a trip that I took before I got sick while we were here in Utah. We went to Moab for about 4 days, photographing the national and state parks there. And this is the first time that I actually went with just my iPhone 15 Pro, which is what I'm using right now to film, which is why I can't hold it. I left the Sony gear at home and I wanted to see what can I do at these parks with just my iPhone. Now, when you look at iPhone photos, one of the most common things that I hear and the things that I see is that they're very sharp. They're sharp from foreground to background. And that can be a good thing. I mean, that's important, rather sharp than out of focus. But in order to really have a compelling composition, you need to draw the viewer's eye through the frame. And there are two primary ways that you can do that. The first is using light. So using bright areas and dark areas, dodging and burning. That's there for a reason to guide your viewer through the frame. But there's also another way, and that is using sharpness or areas that are sharp and areas that aren't, which is why we have bokeh. Unfortunately, the iPhone doesn't have a variable aperture. You can't set it to 1.8 or 2.8 or 16. It uses softer to simulate that. Unless you're using portrait mode, you have to pretty much do it after the fact. Good news is, though, that in October at Adobe Max, when Adobe updated the Lightroom, one of the things that they added was lens blur. Now, at the end of this video, I will link to another video that I did where I go into exactly how lens blur works on desktop and mobile. So I'm not going to go too deep there, but in this video, I'm going to show you three examples of how lens blur can actually improve mobile photography, specifically with the iPhone. So again, I'm using the iPhone 15 Pro Max, but if you're using just about any mobile camera, lens blur should become your friend because it'll elevate the look of your photo significantly by kind of simulating that shallow depth of field. Let me show you. All right, so I promise you none of this is going to be especially crazy, but that's the whole point. When you use a tool like lens blur, it's all about subtlety. So here, this is a photo I took at Arches National Park just about a week ago. At sunset, we were getting some crazy colors when the sun was getting low at the horizon. So I took this photo, as you can see here, 15 Pro Max, and all I'm gonna do is go to the edit tools here. Now I already edited the photo. If I press and hold the backslash, that's the original photo, and then here's my edit. So the lens blur panel is all the way at the bottom here. You can see it's still under early access, which kind of means it's a beta, but here's how I use it. The first thing that I do is click on the apply button here, and this is going to allow Lightroom to kind of estimate the depth and create a depth map. Now, the first thing that I do, it's the complete opposite of subtlety. I actually take the blur amount or the strength slider and I bring it to 100. And that allows me to visualize a bit more easily where blur is being applied. With the blur amount at 100, I then move to the focal range here. So this tool here, if I drag this to the left, basically anything that's inside this box here will be in focus, and anything outside will be out of focus. And you see these colors here. So yellow generally means things that are closest to the frame, so things down here. And then as it gets to blue and magenta, it goes further back. So what this is saying is that the things that are further back, because they're in the colors here are in this box, those will be in focus, and everything that falls outside of it will be out of focus, which is what I want. And to visualize that, watch, I'm gonna take the focus box here and I'm gonna bring it towards the foreground. And as I do, you see how the foreground's getting sharp and the background's getting blurry. So again, I want the opposite of that. So I'm gonna bring this all the way out here. And then I can also choose to click on this bumper here and I can make the range wider so I can bring more of that foreground into focus, or I can make it narrower and bring more of the foreground out of focus, which will really bring the eye towards the background, but I don't like that. This just doesn't look right. So I'm gonna keep it kind of where it was, like right around here. So now that I have the general idea of where the out of focus area is, I can go back to the blur amount here and I'm gonna bring this back down like significantly. You don't need a lot. Here, this is a bit too weak, so I'll bring it up a little bit. And that's actually looking pretty good. I might even try it a little bit more just to see what happens. And I might also bring this range in so we have more of the foreground out of focus. And that's all you really need to do, because what I want you to do is look away from this photo and then look back at it. And you'll see that your eye goes much more quickly to this part of the frame because this area is out of focus. Also, there's not much that's exciting in the foreground here. I didn't want to crop it in much more. I actually like this composition, having this horizon here on the top third of the frame. So I decided to use lens blur. And you can click on the eye icon over here to see the lens blur effect turned off. And then when you let go, it'll be restored. Now, remember, I've got a video that I'm going to link to at the end here where I'm going to go over all of these different tools and sliders. And you might be wondering, well, I know that Lightroom Mobile has lens blur. Why are you showing it to me on the desktop? And the reason for that is because on Lightroom Mobile, you can apply that blur and you can kind of control a little bit where the blur should be applied. But on desktop, you get a lot more control. So if we look here on mobile, you only have basically these two icons. You don't have this arrange control and you don't have the brushing capability if you want to use that. And for me, whenever I use lens blur, I pretty much use the blur amount slider, which is on mobile, but also this specific focal range tool over here, which is not on mobile. All right, let's move on to the next image over here. So another situation here where applying a little bit of blur can take a very busy photo and make it a little bit more easy to follow. So here you can see we have pretty much everything in focus. Again, this is pretty common with mobile photos. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on apply here to enable lens blur. And Lightroom pretty much did what I wanted it to do. I actually wanted to blur the background and keep these hoodoos here in the foreground in focus, but it's a bit too aggressive. So just like before, let's take the blur amount and jack it up to 100 so we can really see. And then remember, right now, everything that's as close to me as possible is in focus, and that's true, but then this guy right here is kind of out of focus. So what I need to do is take the handlebar here from the range box and extend it until I start to see that hoodoo get sharp, which is right around here. I can go even a little bit further just to make sure that we have a nice clean line right here, which we do. And now with this new focal range defined, I can go ahead and ease off on the blur amount. And so you can see here, now we have this nice separation. If you want, you can make it even stronger if you want to have that really strong simulated shallow depth of field. But for me, I actually like it to be a little bit more subtle. All right, let's go to one more photo here. This one was taken at Arches National Park. All right, so here you can see, as before, everything from foreground to background is in focus. And I intentionally put this kind of brush over here in the foreground because I want to create a natural frame. I also like the kind of green color that plays against the orange rock, but it's just too much. There's too much stuff that's in focus. So let's go ahead and click on apply. And so you can see here that Lightroom did identify that pretty much everything that's far away should be in focus. But I do want to adjust this a little bit more. So what I'm going to do is take the left bumper here and bring it out so you can see what happens as I adjust this. You see how as I do this, more of the stuff closer to me is in focus? I actually don't want that. So what I'm going to do is make it even narrower until I get basically everything that's in the foreground blurry, which is right around here. Now that I have that mask selected, I can go ahead here. I actually forgot to bring it to 100%. We don't need that. It's overkill here. But what I'm going to do is just bring it right around here, like really low, really subtle. In fact, I might bring it back even more to around 10, just to give it a little bit of softness. Because again, if we hide the effect, you can see every little crispy edge of the plant. But when I let go, it gets just a little soft. And that softness is enough for your eye to say, okay, I don't want to focus on this. Let me go up here. And that's like the best trick that I could recommend while you're using lens blur. Make your changes, look away for 5-10 seconds, and then look back and see if your eye does what you want your viewer's eye to do. Does it go to where you want your viewer's eye to go? If so, you've got it going on. If not, make some more adjustments, look away, and then look back. And that's really just how easy it is to use lens blur. Specifically with mobile photos, it works with any camera, obviously, but because mobile photos are so sharp from foreground to background, something like lens blur really will benefit. That's kind of why Apple even built the portrait mode, because they know that when you take a normal photo of a person against the background, everything's in focus. So let's use some software, some computational photography to simulate that shallow depth of field. And so with that, I am wrapping up 2023. I want to thank all of you so much for all of your support. This has been the best year for my business that I can remember. For everyone who's enrolled in Lightroom Everywhere, thank you so much. If you're interested, you want to learn everything there is to know about Lightroom, check out the link to my course in the description below. I did mention that there is another video right here that will show you how to use everything in the lens blur panel on desktop and on mobile. If you enjoy this video, a thumbs up is always helpful. Be sure to subscribe and click on the bell icon for more videos, and I will see you guys in 2024.